Hey there, Salesforce Ohana. Welcome to the first episode of Blue Tiger Academy, a channel dedicated to teaching you how to configure Salesforce to solve common business problems. We are a team led by certified Salesforce architects who work for a Salesforce partner called Blue Ninjas. We are passionate about sharing our knowledge and expertise with the Salesforce community. Our mission is to give back to the Salesforce Ohana by providing inspiration, guidance, and support to anyone looking to achieve success on the Salesforce platform. We understand the challenges faced by administrators who often find themselves navigating the Salesforce jungle alone. You solo admins out there, we know exactly how you feel. That's why Blue Tiger Academy exists, to be your trusty guide through the Salesforce ecosystem, equipping you with the best tips, tricks, techniques, to conquer any business challenge. In today's adventure, we're tackling a common challenge that all companies have, and that's the existence of leads in your Salesforce database that are already current customers. Leads come into Salesforce from web forms, white paper downloads, newsletter subscriptions, and so on and so on, and nothing is checking for whether or not they're a current customer. Sales reps end up cold calling these leads only to find out the company is already a customer of yours. It's so embarrassing when that happens. So we've got just the thing to help you out. We have a free package from Blue Ninjas that's called Relate Leads to Accounts. This package will look for a match between the lead's email address domain and the account's website domain. If it finds a match, it will relate the lead to the account, making this information visible right from the lead page. While this won't find all of the leads that exist for your existing customers, it will cut down by at least 50% of the issues that you're seeing. Now, before we start, don't forget to hit subscribe so you never miss another episode of Blue Tiger Academy. All right, so we're going to jump into installing the package. So we are at the Blue Ninjas website. This is the how-to article that shows you how to configure this package and install it. You can find the link in the description below. We are going to click the link right here, and that's going to take us to the AppExchange package. We are going to click Get It Now, and we are going to install this in our developer org. We recommend installing this in your sandbox environment first so that you can test it out and confirm that it's doing everything that you want it to do. You will be presented with this screen where you will need to enter your production username here, and then you choose whether or not you want to put it in production or the sandbox. Since we are in a developer org, we're going to choose install in production. And then we are going to say, I have read and agreed to the terms, and click confirm and install. This is then going to give you another screen where you will enter your Salesforce credentials. You will enter the credentials for the sandbox if you're installing in the sandbox here. If you're installing in production, you will enter your production credentials. And then this is going to take a couple minutes to install, but we should be presented with this screen here. Here we go. So this question up here is asking you, what if existing component names conflict with ones in this package? What this is saying is if you have an existing component in Salesforce, for example, an existing field that's named exactly the same, what do you want the installer to do? So I'd recommend don't install because you want to see what's going on there. You don't want it to overwrite anything and cause any issues in your org. It is safe to install this for all profiles if you want to. It will give edit access to the account lookup that we're going to put on the lead. If you want to test it out just as you, I'm going to show you how you can update the field level security so you can make sure the correct profiles are getting the permissions that you want. So we'll install for admins only for right now. And then you will get a confirmation email when this does successfully install. We will get a screen here that says it's all done when it's ready. All right, so we got installation complete. So we are going to hit done. And then we will be taken to the installation page, the installed packages page here. So you can see the installed package. If you are curious of what the components are, you can always click on the package and you can click View Components, and they will all be listed here. All right. So depending on the settings of your org, you may or may not need to do this step, but first step is to check and make sure that there are three flows that are active in the org. So these are the three flows that we just installed, and they are all active. If you have the setting where flows are installed in the inactive state in your process automation settings, then you'll have to activate these. You just activate them going here, clicking View Details, and then you just click Activate right here. All right, our next step is to update the field level security for, there's four fields in this package. Now on the account object is the first two fields. So we are going to type in website here, and website domain and website domain and path are the two formula fields that were installed. Shout out to Walter Pulowski. Thank you so much for writing these formulas. They are very tricky, and we'll show you how those are working. So you'll go to the field, you'll hit set field level security, and then you will just update the profiles that you want to have access to this field. Click save. You'll repeat the same process over here. And then we'll click save. Then there are two other fields on the lead. So we will go to the object manager. We will go to lead. And the first one is the account lookup. We will set field level security. And this one, you may want to give them edit access to this, because you know, if there isn't a match found with this package, the sales rep can still link the lead to the account if they wanted to. So you will just give access to whichever users need access. If you want it to be read only, go ahead and set that. The other field on the lead object is called email domain. We'll go there and we'll hit set field level security, and we will give access to the two profiles here as well, and we'll hit save. All right, next step is to add the new fields to your page layouts. So you're going to go to, stay in the lead object, you're going to go to the page layout, and you're going to add the account lookup to the page layout. Okay, so we come up here, we're going to hover over this field called account. We can see that the API name is BN underscore account. So that is the field that we want. So I'm going to drag it right here underneath company. I'm going to save that. If you have any other lead page layouts, go ahead and modify those. And then I'm going to go to the account page layout, and I'm going to add a couple of fields. You do not need to do this step. This is completely up to you if you are curious on how this is working. So I'm gonna add with the website domain and path and the website domain. So these two fields do some of the heavy lifting to strip out the extraneous characters out of the website field so that we can just get the domain out. Oh, there's one other step on the account. We want to add the lead related list to the account page. So we're going to find leads right here. We can add leads wherever you want. I'll drop it there. I'm going to add email field, and then we'll save that. Okay. Now that's it. That's all you've got to do. So we are now going to test this out. So we are going to go to the sales app, and we have an account called Blue Ninjas right here. And we can see the website has HTTPS and colons and forward slashes. And we can see the website domain is stripping out all of that information. So if you have anything after the .com, it will also strip that out. So I'll show you what that looks like too. So you can see that this formula field gets everything after the www or anything else that you have in front of there. And then this field just gets the domain. So that's what's used for the matching for the leads. All right, so now let's go to our leads. And we are going to make a lead have a Blue Ninja's email address. So let's go to Betty. And we're going to update Betty to work at Blue Ninjas. So we're going to change Betty's company to Blue Ninjas here. And we are going to update Betty's address to be, have a blueninjas.com domain. Now we can see that the account lookup here, this is how the lead is going to get related to the account. We can see this is blank. Now once we hit save, we will see that the flows go out and look for a matching account and update the account record here, right on the lead. Now, if we go back to the Blue Ninjas account and we go to the lead related list and we refresh this, we will be able to see Betty is now listed as a lead underneath this account. So right here, we can see Betty is linked. Now, let's say that you wanted to provide your sales reps with a message that says, hey, Betty is related to an existing customer. Don't reach out, don't cold call. So we can put a message right here on the right-hand side of the lead record page. So we're gonna go to the lead object in setup, and we're gonna go to Lightning Record Pages. And if you don't have a Lightning Record page, you'll create a new one. But if you do have one, go ahead and edit it here. And then we are going to drag and drop a rich text over here on the right-hand side. And we are gonna write in here, this lead is a current customer. Do not cold call. All right, and we're gonna make that a little bit bigger. And we're gonna make it red. You don't have to make it red if you don't want to. All right, you just want it to stand out enough so that they don't miss it. Okay, now you can also put this, you can put this as a banner across here if you want to and make it center if you don't like the way that it looks on the side panel. It's up to you. So you can make it be a banner across there, put it in the side panel, do whatever you like. I'm going to keep it over here on the left hand side. And then we only want this text to show if the lead is related to a current customer. So if we go back to the Blue Ninjas account page, we can see that the type field is telling whether or not, telling us that they are a current customer. So we have prospect, customer direct, customer channel, and right now Blue Ninjas is listed as a technology partner. I'm going to go ahead and change them to a customer dash channel. I'm going to go back to my lead record page and I'm going to add a filter here. I'm going to click advanced and then select, then select record, account, and then I want the type field. And then when the type equals customer channel, or the type field equals customer direct, I want this message to show. Let's see here, count, type, all right. And now we're gonna scroll down here to the logic and we're gonna say if any of these filters are true, show this card on the side here. I'll click save. And then we're going to go back to Betty's page. We're going to hit refresh and we should see that message pop up. Yep, there it is. All right, now let's go back to the Blue Ninjas account page. And now let's make Blue Ninjas a technology partner again. What we would expect to have happen is when we refresh, we won't see that lead message anymore about them being a customer. So that went away. So we are all set. So now we have a message that is going to show hide based on whether or not the account is a current customer. And our sales reps will be notified whenever, you know, somebody who is an existing customer comes in, they'll be automatically linked to the account. Now, there are some other things that can happen too. So what if the website changes on the account? What's going to happen? So let's go ahead and do that. So let's say we're going to change the website to be Blue Ninjas Test. So our domain is now Blue Ninjas Test. So those two leads that did match before, they don't match anymore. So you can see that they're no longer linked to Blue Ninjas. They're automatically updated as soon as the website on the account is updated. So if we go back to Betty's page and we hit refresh, we'll see that the account lookup is blank. If we go back to the Blue Ninjas page and we update the website to be blueninjas.com, then we go back to Betty's page, we should see that Blue Ninjas is now populated in this account. And it is. It's all set. All right. And that's it. You have just configured the Relate Leads to Accounts application. Now we do have a second part of this app where we will show you how you can add a button here right on the leads related list on the account page that will allow you to select the leads and mass convert more than one lead at a time and relate it to this account as a contact. Super cool stuff. Be looking for that video called Mass Convert Leads from the Account Page. Well, that's it. That's a wrap for our first episode from Blue Tiger Academy. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and do let us know in the comments what you liked, what you didn't like, and what else you want to see coming out of this channel. See you next time. Thanks. Bye.